Students, today we'll discuss about another physics paper, JEE Mains Physics 2014. So let us discuss all those questions one by one. Okay. Students, let us move to the next question. Question number 8: the pressure that has to be applied to the ends of a steel wire of length 10 centimeters. Steel wire of length 10 centimeters. So this is steel wire whose one end is, suppose I am fixing one end, and the length is 10 centimeters. To keep it, the pressure is applied to the ends. So both the ends, the pressure is applied. Okay, pressure is applied at both ends. To keep its length constant, to keep this length constant, because you apply pressure, then there is a change in the length. So to keep the length constant, when its temperature is raised by 100 degrees centigrade is. That means now whatever is temperature now, suppose the temperature now is theta I, theta is for initial temperature, and the final temperature will become 100 plus theta I, because the change has to be, it is to be 100 degrees centigrade. So this is the initial temperature, this is the final temperature. So I'll write the change in temperature delta theta as 100 degrees centigrade. That is a change in temperature. So we know that from coefficient of linear expansion of substance, when you heat a substance, its temperature rise, and there is a change in the length of the substance. In case of a rod, its length will increase. In case of wire, its length will increase. So there is a linear expansion along the length. So if this is the length corresponding to some theta I, then by the raise in temperature of 100 degrees centigrade, suppose the length has to be like this. That means the wire wants extension of some value, suppose delta L. But then we want to overcome this elongation, because our question is to keep the length constant. So it wants to expand, and you have to apply force or a pressure in the opposite direction, so that this length is is counterbalanced. So against this expansion, how much pressure that has to be applied, the pressure that has to be applied to maintain this length. Now this is the question, and everything else is the data is given. Y value is given to 10 raised to 11 newton per meter square. This is the Young's modulus. Coefficient of thermal expansion, that is linear expansion basically, the coefficient of linear expansion is alpha, which is 1.1 and 10 to the power minus 5 Kelvin raised to minus 1. Whether it's Kelvin raised to minus 1 or a degree centigrade raised to minus 1, this doesn't make any difference, because we are interested in the change in temperature. So the change in temperature in degree centigrade scale and Kelvin scale is same. So therefore it is not going to affect any change in the result, whether this is per Kelvin or per degree centigrade. Now the question is to find the pressure. To find the pressure, you must know that Young's modulus is given by the longitudinal stress upon the longitudinal strain. That is, the stress is a force per area, and the strain is delta L over L. This is the formula for Young's modulus. Now we are interested in the pressure, this pressure which creates the expansion, and this exact amount of pressure has to be applied. So the applied pressure is F by A, which comes out to be Y delta L over L. This is the applied force per area, that is the pressure. So against this pressure, I have to apply equal amount of this pressure. So whatever is the value of this, that is our required result. So this is the pressure. This pressure comes out to be Y delta L over L. But then from the given data, we have Y, we have L, but we don't have delta L. So as I told you, this delta L corresponds to the expansion the wire will undergo when it is heated from one temperature of theta I to 100 plus theta I. So whenever there is a change in temperature of 100 degree centigrade. So I have to relate this expansion of delta L with the change in temperature delta theta. How is that done? Now that is done using from thermal expansion from thermal expansion from the experiment, which is found that the increase in length LT minus L0 is equal to some constant original length and change in temperature. So this is the change in length. Here the change in length I told you is delta L. So this will be replaced by delta L is equal to alpha. This is the original length, so I'll replace this by L, because in our case the original length was L and that is delta theta. So from here, if I make one more step, this is delta L. L is divided, this side becomes alpha delta theta. So this delta L over L, which is alpha delta theta, is put here in this expression of delta L by L. I put alpha delta theta, so this expression becomes Y alpha delta theta. So this is the pressure that is acting, and this has to be the pressure to be applied externally to balance the to maintain the constant length. So to maintain constant length, this pressure has to be applied, and that you have to solve. Now from your question, I'll just put the data Y alpha and delta theta there. So Y is given as 2 times 10 raised to 11 alpha, because I have taken proper units, so I'm not writing the units. That will automatically cancel out and give you Newton per meter square. So alpha is 1.1 10 raised to minus 5, and delta theta is obviously 100. Now if I solve, and obviously the answer will be Newton per meter square. Here it is 2.2, this 2 and 1.1, this will be 2.2, and the rest is the game of only 10 power of something. Here is 10 raised to 11 and the 2 comes out, 10 raised to 13, here is 10 raised to minus 5. So 13 minus 5 is how much? It is 8, okay, into 10 raised to 8. 8 plus 5 is 13. So therefore this should be the answer. To see the answer, we have to see the options, and you must note that Newton per meter square is also known as Pascal. This also is Pascal. So it's 2.2 10 raised to 8 Pascal. 2.2 10 raised to 8 Pascal is the first one, and that is the right answer to this question. You can see here 2.2 10 raised to 8 Pascal, 2.2 10 raised to 8 Pascal. But this Pascal or Newton per meter square, it means the same thing. Okay, thank you.